Hi there, welcome, and if this is the first video that you're watching from my channel, you can click right here to the left side to watch all of the free videos that I already posted. There are a bunch of them, so you can catch up, and you can click right here to the right to subscribe to this channel, because this is where I'm going to post all of my new videos. There are a lot of them coming up, alright? Another thing I want to talk about is this. Itong schedule ng mga natitirang review events for the October exam. Under Study Link Review Center, there are numbers right here. I'm going to be in Iloilo on September 17 to 18 to teach, and also I'm going to be in Antique naman the following week, September 24 to 25. So if you want to attend one of these events, kung dito kayo malapit, you can call them dito sa number na to, 500-2663. Or 0921-611-9798. Alright? And after that, I'm going to be with JJ Review and Training Center. It's going to be my first time there. It's going to be in Aklan on October 1 to 2. You can contact them at 0908-812-8354 to reserve your slot and to ask for the process. For StudyLink and for JJ Review, I'm not in charge of the logistics, so you can contact them to ask for the price and register and all of the freebies. If they have anything like that arranged, you can ask them for that. The next two venues are going to be in Baguio, October 8 to 9, and Davao, October 15 to 16. If you want to attend one of these venues, you can reach out directly to me at www.facebook.com/teamlyqa. Send me a message there so I can send you the registration instructions. For these two events, I'm going to be handling everything, so I can tell you right away that the fee is 2,000 for new students and 1,500 for those who already have a workbook with them. You can ask me for more information about that if you're interested. Alright? Okay, so ito yung ating bagong request video. This time I'm going to talk about each problem. So if you haven't seen batch 1, you can click here, dito sa left side, so you can see kung ano yung mga questions na nasagot ko na. Okay, sa first one, we focused on ratio problems, iba-ibang klase ng ratio problems, so you can watch that video right here, so you can catch up. Okay? Okay, here's the first question. This was sent in by Nancy Camia. It's an age problem. All of these are age problems, iba-iba lang ng form. This question reads, 6 years ago, the ratio of the ages of Marcus and Gabriel was 6:5. 4 years hence, the ratio of their ages will be 11:10. What is Gabriel's age at present? Ngayon, when it comes to age problems, this is actually a complicated, a rather complicated question. I want you to follow along, pero keep in mind that the questions naman in the civil service exam won't be this tricky. Combination na kasi ito ng ratio at saka ng age problem. And when it comes to age problems, the technique that I'm going to teach you is yung table technique. I already have a video on age problems. You can click right here, sa right side, to watch that video. I just made one, so I'm planning to make more, but for now, ito muna yung gamitin natin. When it comes to age problems, like I said, all you need to do is to create a table. Okay, ngayon, ang next na question is, ano yung ilalagay sa table? What I do is, I make sure na ang number of rows ay yung dami ng tao. In this problem, there are only two people, si Marcus tsaka si Gabriel. And then, yung number naman ng columns, ang magdedetermine ng number of columns is the number of time periods. Okay? Time periods na na-indicate doon sa problem. In this problem, meron tayong 6 years ago, meron tayong now, kasi yung nahanap, present, and meron tayong 4 years hence. And the first question is, ano yung ibig sabihin ng hence? Ang hence basically means mula ngayon. So, parang 4 years from now. Okay? Now, what do we need to do? Dahil mayroon tatlong age, may tatlong time periods, i-divide natin yung table. Meron kayong ngayong tatlong periods. Ito yung 6 years ago. So, 6 years ago. Ito yung now. And this is 4 years hence. Okay? Ngayon, Dahil meron ka ngayong dalawang tao at tatlong age, tatlong time periods, you can start plotting yung mga given. Ngayon, bakit ganito yung nakalagay sa akin? Kasi in my mind, okay, may timeline tayo. Okay? Remember when you use timelines, laging zero, tapos dito yung negative, dito yung positive. So, ibig sabihin nun, yung brain natin, nakaset na siya na sanay siya mag-process information like that. Negative sa left side, positive sa right side. And if you think about it, yung noun natin, ito yung zero point noong timeline. Ito yung minus, ito yung plus. Okay? Para madaling isipin. Kasi, yung 6 years ago basically means minus 6 noong now. And 4 years hence basically means plus 4. And that will be a recurring theme dito sa isasolve natin problem. Now that you have your table set up, syempre, the more that you solve problems like these, mas bibilis kayo. Pero ang importante, tama yung setup ng table ninyo. You can go back to the problem to plot kung ano yung mga given. And ang unang condition is that 6 years ago, ang ratio ng ages daw nila was 6 is to 5. So if you think about it, you can say that kung ang age ni Marcus ay 6, okay, si Gabriel ay 5. Ngayon, bakit yon? Kasi kung ano yung nauuna, siya yung nauuna. Nahuhuli, siya yung nahuhuli. So 6 is to 5. Pero ito, ratio siya. Hindi siya actual age. So kung ratio siya, what you could do would be to put in an x as a factor. So ibig sabihin, ratio niya 6 is to 5. Kung ano man yung x na yan, hindi pa natin alam. Okay? Ngayon, meron siyang syempreng age now. Kung 6 years ago ito, at minus 6 yan, in order for you to get 0, you're going to add whatever you need para makancel tong negative 6 na yan. So, kung ang 6x siya before, ang age niya ngayon ay 6x plus 6. This would be 5x plus 6 din. Saan galing yung 6? Kasi nga, kung ito yung 6 years ago, syempre kung now, nadagdagan na ng 6 na taon, ito yung 6 na yan, ito yung plus 6 na yan. And if dito naman sa side na to, 4 years hence, ibig sabihin, from now until the future, ano naman ang age niya niyan? Kung 6x plus 6 siya dito, this should be 6x plus 10. This naman would be 5x plus 11, plus 10. Sorry, 5x plus 10 then. So, pareho silang may plus 10. Bakit again 10? Kasi plus 6 para maging now, plus 4 para maging in the future. So, ito yung age nila following yung track nitong 6x, 5x. Pero meron pa isang given, which is 4 years hence, the ratio of their ages will be 11 is to 10. So again, si Marcus would be 11, si Gabriel would be 10 of a factor. So what you can do here, following this line of thinking, is that you can say na 11x ito, 10x naman siya. Okay? Ngayon, ano na yung pwede natin gawin? When it comes to age problems, ang hahanapin mo ay nasaan yung pwede mong gawing equation. Ano yung condition na pwede mong gawing equation? The word equation, okay, comes from this, no? Equate or equal. Hanapin mo kung anong conditions yung pwede mong gawing equal. Gagawa ka ng equality. Ngayon, if you look at this, sabi 6x plus 10, pareho siya ng 11x. Again, it's describing the same thing. So, you can use that as your equation. 6x plus 10 is equal to 11x. Okay? And then, you can solve it down. Kasi ang hinahanap naman na, you can do that, or kaya lang dahil ang hinahanap na ng question is si Gabriel, to save time, dahil si Gabriel ang hinahanap, you can use this instead. Yung age ni Gabriel diretso na para yung ano mo yung sagot mo yun na yun. Pero either way, actually would work kasi ipa-plot mo pa naman dun sa actual na age nila. So this would be 5x plus 10 naman is equal to 10x. Okay? So we can do that. Solve it down. So this would be 5x is equal to 5x plus 10 is equal to 10x. Again, I like to keep my x's positive. So, you can say 10 is equal to, ito ang ililipat natin sa kabila. Pag nilipat mo sa kabila, magiging minus na siya. 10x minus 5x is 10. This is equal to 5x. Di-divide mo both sides by 5 para makancel ito. This would be 2. So, x is equal to 2. Pero hindi pa yan ang age niya, okay? Kasi ang hinahanap is Gabriel's age at present. Nasaan yun? Ito si Gabriel, now. Ito yun, 5x plus 6. So, ano yung 5x plus 6? Okay. You can just insert yung kung ano yung nakita nating x dito. So, 5 times 2 plus 6. Okay, so that would be 10 plus 6. So, Gabriel's age is 16 years old. Ngayon, how can we check it? You can do a number of things. You can look at yung past. So, kung 16 years old siya dito, dapat 10 siya dito. At kung 10 siya dito, then this, Marcus naman would be 12 years old. Kasi, di ba, if you solve this naman, this is 2 times 6, 12, or tas dito naman, 12 plus 6 is 18. 12 plus 10 is 22. And, si Gabriel naman would be 20. So, ang ratio ng ages nila noon is 12 is to 10, or 12 over 10, na pwede natin paliitin, magiging 6 over 5. So, kung 6 over 5, 6 and 5, check na tayo dito sa first condition. In the future naman, it's 22 over 20. Again, if you convert this into smallest terms, this would be 11 over 10, which is, ito namang second condition natin, 11 over 10. So, tama tayo on both sides. So, ang age ni Gabriel is 16 years old. Okay? So, when you're more familiar with age problems, it's not going to take you that long. I solved this problem in about maybe 30 seconds. Simply because I'm familiar with making the table na. So, I suggest that you keep practicing. If hindi nyo nakuha agad, something that people do is, when they watch the video, pinapause nila pa isa-isa, and then they go back and try to solve it by themselves. That's something that you can do. Okay? So, thank you, Nancy, for this question. This is a very tricky question for newbies, but I think you can solve it if magpa-practice kayo well. Okay? Here's another question. Each problem din siya. This was sent by, I think this is Elmer Dakanay. Ito kasi yung kanyang Facebook handle. Sabi, 2 years ago, Harish was thrice as old as his brother, Krish. 2 years later, Harish will be twice as old as Krish. Find the present age of Krish. So again, same principle. You create a table. Alright? Ilan yung tao? Meron tayong si Harish at si Krish. Okay? Ilan yung time period? Meron siyang 2 years ago. And then, 2 years later. And then, ang hinahanap is present age ni Krish. Okay? So, kung niyari, kung ito si Harish, ito si Krish, meron kayong tatlong time period. You have now, 2 years ago, which is basically minus 2, and then 2 years later, which would be plus 2 naman. Okay? So, sabi, 2 years ago, so nandito yun sa column na ito, si Harish daw was thrice as old as his brother Krish. So, ano ibig sabihin nun? Kung si Krish ay X, si Harish ay 3 times ng age ni Krish. Okay? Ngayon, sabi, 2 years later, Harish will be twice as old as Krish. Ngayon, even before we go there, you can, if you're having a hard time with the number line, diba sabi ko nga again, ito yung negative, ito yung positive. So, this is in, ito ay in negative 2 pa. Para ma-zero nyo muna siya, you can fill this in. So, 3x plus 2. This would be x plus 2. Again, saan ang galing yung 2? Kasi binabawi natin yung utang na dalawa dito para maging now siya. Okay? And in the future naman, dahil 2 years siya after nung 0 point, you can add another 2 here. This would be 3x plus 4. And this would be x plus 4. Okay? And ang second condition is that 2 years later, Harish will be twice as old as Krish. So, ibig sabihin, ito ay imumultiply natin sa dalawa, ito dapat yung magiging answer. So, again, dahil naghahanap tayo ng equation or equality, yun na yung pwede natin gawing equation. Again, ha, sabi kasi, twice as old siya pagdating ng 2 years later. So, kung ano man ito, times 2 should be equal to this. That would be our equation for this problem. So, 3x plus 4 is equal to 2 times ng x plus 4. That's, yun yung kung saan galing yung equation. This is where people find each problem difficult kasi hindi nila alam kung saan nila huhugutin yung equation. Okay? But through practice, again, you would be more familiar with that. Hahanapin mo lang kung ano, saan ka kukuha ng, saan ka huhugot ng equation dito. Okay? So, 3x plus 4, wala na tayo magagawa dyan, is equal to, and then you have to distribute this. Okay? So, 2x plus 8. So, 3x, and then isi-switch over natin. Like I said, I like keeping my x's positive. So, 3x minus 2x is equal to 8 minus 4. X is equal to 4. Pero again, this is not yet the final answer. Ipa-plug in mo pa siya. Ang hinahanap natin is the present age of Krish. Ito yon, x plus 2. So, ang x plus 2 is equal to yung age ni Krish at present now. Okay, and you can plug this in here. This would be 4 plus 2. So, ang age ni Krish would be 6. 6 years old siya. Okay? Ngayon, try natin yun i-check. Okay? Kung 6 years old si Krish dito, ang edad niya 2 years ago is 4. Ang edad ni Harish, which is 3 times nung 4, should be 12. Harish would be 14 here, and then 16 here. Si Krish naman would be 8 years old here. Tama ba tayo? Yes, kasi 8 times 2 is 16. So, tama tayo doon. Again, ang age ni Chris should be 6 years old. 6 years old siya. Now. Okay? Yun yung present age niya. Next problem. This is from Gerald Ludor. So, thank you for sending this in. Sabi, Mar is age 3 times more than his son, Mikoy. After 8 years, he would be 2.5 times of Mikoy's age. After further 8 years, how many times would he be of Mikoy's age? So, this problem, maliban sa marami siyang run on at medyo weird yung pagkakakonstruct, this is a little, again, little complicated. But I'm going to help you solve this. I don't think it's going to be this hard naman pagdating sa exam, but mas maganda nang prepared kayo. Okay? So, same principle lang din. All you have to do is to first create your table. Okay? Ilan ang tao? We have Mar and Mikoy. So, dalawa rin yung row. Ilan yung time period? Sabi, ito, Mar is, pag sinabing is, ibig sabihin this is present. Okay? So, syempre, meron kang now. Okay? Meron kang now, meron kang after 8 years, and then after further 8 years. Ano ibig sabihin after further 8 years? Ibig sabihin, may 8 years ka lang dinagdag, may 8 years pa siya uli. So, kung lalagay natin to sa number line natin, we have, sabihin natin si Mar, and this is Mikoy. Okay? Si, at kung ito yung now, okay, this would be the after 8 years, so this would be plus 8, and then meron ka pang further, after further 8 years, which is another plus 8, tatlong time period. At ang hinahanap is yung kung how many times would he be of Mikoy's age. Hindi yung age nilang hinahanap, kundi yung multiple, ano yung multiply mo sa age ni Mikoy para makuha mo yung age ni Mar, yung kanyang tatay. So, before you even stress about that, you can try to construct the equation first. So, sabi, Mar is aged 3 times more than his son Mikoy. That is right now. So, kung si Mikoy right now is 8 and is X years old, si Mar would be 3X years old. Ano bakit 3X? Kasi 3 times siya more than Mikoy. Now, after 8 years, again, this is plus 8. So, after 8 years, Mar would be 3X plus 8 years old. Mikoy would be X plus 8 years old. Okay? And then, sabi, after 8 years, he would be 2.5 times of Mikoy's age. So, ibig sabihin, this one right here, pag minultiply mo siya sa 2.5, would be this. Okay? So, may clue na tayo ng equation natin. At ang hinahanap is, after 8 years, kung ano man to, ano yung multiple niya? Again, nakita na natin meron na tayong equation dito, so you can just plot it. So, x plus 8 times 2.5 is equal to 3x plus 8. Okay? Ngayon, kahit may decimal yan, don't be afraid. You can solve it naman very easily. Again, i-distribute lang natin to. This will be 2.5x plus, and then 8 times 2.5. So, dalawang 8, which is 16, plus kalahating 8, which is 4. That is just 20, is equal to 3x plus 8. And then to try to keep x's as positive as possible, dito natin siya ililipat, yung 8 ang ililipat natin sa kabila. So 20 minus 8 is equal to 3x minus 2.5x. So this would be 12 and it's equal to 0.5x. Ngayon, anong gagawin natin next dito? It's actually very easy. 0.5, try natin siya gawing 1. So what do you have to multiply to 0.5 para maging 1 siya? Since that is 1 half, you have to multiply it by 2. So, imu-multiply mo both sides by 2. Kasi ang rule sa algebra is that whatever you do sa right side, you have to do sa left para fair. This is 24 is equal to x. X is equal to 24. Ibig sabihin, si Mikoy now is 24 years old. Ang tatay niya is 72 years old, but that doesn't matter. Ang hinahanap natin is kung ano yung relationship nitong dalawa. Kasi ang hinahanap is how many times would he be of Mikoy's age. So kung 24 si Mikoy nung ngayon, after 8 years, si Mikoy ay magiging 32 years old. After another 8 years, si Mikoy would be 40 years old. Okay? Ngayon, sabi natin, again, 24 siya, ang tatay niya would be 72, which is basically just 24 times 3. Kung 72 siya before, after 8 years, he would become 80 years old. And then after another 8 years, magiging 88 years old siya. Ngayon, to confirm, again, you can check here, 32 times 2.5 is 80. So 32 times 2, 64, plus kalahati noon, which is 16, is 80. So check tayo dyan. Ang inahanap na natin ngayon is, ano yung imumultiply mo kay Mikoy para maging 88 siya. Okay? So, ang traditional method niyan is basically like this. So, 40 times something, which is x, is equal to 88. Okay? So, and then you divide both sides by 40. So, x, to cancel this, so x is equal to 88 over 40. Again, what you can do would be to either divide this again agad ng long cut, or you can put this into smallest terms para sandali i-handle. Pareho silang even, so pwede sa 2. 44 over 20, pareho, pwede uli sa 2, pero nakikita na natin dito, malinaw naman, pwede again, pwede sila both sa 4. So you can write 11 over 10. So how many times would he be of Mikoy's age? Ano yung kailangan mo i-multiply para lumabas yung age ni Mikoy? It's 11 over 10. Or kung gusto mo na i-decimal point yan, that is basically 20 divided by 4 is 5. So sorry for that. So that's 11 over 5. Yeah, 11 over 5. So that would be 2 and 1 over 5 or 2.2. Okay? So 2.2 ang kailangan mo i-multiply sa age ni Mikoy para maging age siya ni Mar. So, ang sagot na after further 8 years, how many times would he be of Mikoy's age? He would be 2.2 times ng Mikoy's age. Okay? So, that's it. Again, this is a rather complicated question, but if you understand the principles, that's how you solve it. Ngayon, do you have to learn all of this, all of the things I did in order for you to pass the exam? Not really. But I suggest that you master kung paano gumawa nitong age table natin and kung paano maghanap ng equality. Yun lang ang dalawang skills na kailangan ninyo in order to solve age problems. And then babalik lang kayo sa table. Sa nagkakaroon ng pagkakamali yung mga tao sa age problems, number one, hindi nila tama yung pagkakagawa nila ng table. And number two, hindi nila alam kung saan sila kukuha ng equation. Okay? So, this requires a lot of analysis. So, again, with that, a lot of practice. Okay? So, again, if you haven't seen the other videos, you can click right here on the left side. Click on the right to subscribe to this channel to find out as soon as my new video posts. I'm planning to make a series on mixture and age problems really soon. As soon as meron akong time, I can start making that na. Okay, so please don't quit. I know this is a bunch of tricky questions, but again, with practice, you will develop the skill that you need in order to solve this ng off the top of your head ng madaling-madali lang. Okay, I'll keep praying for you guys. God bless, and aja-aja, kaya niyo yan. Keep learning, keep believing, keep praying, kaya niyo yan. And I believe that if you have faith in God, that would help you have faith in yourself para makapas kang exam. So I'll be praying for all of you guys. God bless. Kaya niyan. Bye-bye.